top 10 UFO sighting that is not fake. We have come across a lot of news on UFO sighting which we proved to be fake. People claim UFO sighting to become famous. We're here to bring you top 10 UFO sightings that are not fake. What are the different types of UFO? There are various types of UFO, and it is unclear what they are in many cases. There are also unexplained sightings of what looks to be flying discs, triangle-shaped UFO, and phenomena that resemble the Aurora Borealis. It appears that many scientists and astronomers believe there is a scientific explanation for everything, but various countries have also filed reports of UFO. How might UFO be explained? UFO. Unidentified flying objects are often a topic of conversation and debate. They have been captured on video and photos in many cases. It is unclear what these objects are. They could be from other planets, they could be cars and planes, or they could just be something we have invented for entertainment. I think these are just either cars and airplanes or people who are making up stories. How are UFO sightings dealt with by governments? UFO sightings can be a complex and controversial subject. On one hand, people who witness a UFO sighting feel like they have seen something that cannot be explained. On the other hand, for governments trying to figure out what is happening, there can be numerous other explanations. This creates a lot of tension on both ends of the spectrum. Typically, UFO sightings that are deemed credible are investigated by the government. The US government investigates UFO sightings on a case-by-case basis. So, where sighting is deemed important to the government, it will invest more resources into finding out why the UFO is there. Even during those investigations, there are cases where UFO cannot be identified. First, Ohio sighting. Air traffic controllers scrambled jets to intercept a UFO over Dayton, Ohio, after reports of an unidentified aircraft were received by the FAA. The UFO was traveling at approximately 5,000 feet according to FAA radar, and air traffic controllers were unable to contact the aircraft. Potential reasons for the increase in the number of UFO reports include an increase in UFO sightings, a desire to be famous, or the possibility that there really is an increased number of UFO in the sky. Second, Warminster UFO incidents. The Warminster UFO incidents were reported in 1965 and 1967, with various witnesses seeing unusual lights in the sky. One sighting was reported by a school teacher and 27 of her students. They all saw a silver, metallic object, which hovered for a short while before gradually disappearing. Third, the Kecksburg UFO incident. The Kecksburg UFO incident was reported in December 1965, with witnesses claiming to see an object that was between 60 and 100 feet in length and shaped like a football. Fourth, the Lonnie Zamora UFO sighting. There have been several sightings throughout the world, but one of the most notable is the Lonnie Zamora UFO sighting in Socorro, New Mexico. In 1964, Lonnie Zamora was on patrol when a large, silent object crossed the highway just in front of him. Lonnie was the only witness to the unusual event. He reported to the local police that he saw a spacecraft and landed in a field to pick up gravel for a construction job. Fifth, the Rendlesham Forest incident. On the night of December 26, 1980, strange lights were reported in the sky near two U.S. Air Force bases in Suffolk, England, called RAF Woodbridge and RAF Bentwaters. After a series of investigations and examinations, UFO believers claim that the event is proof of extraterrestrial life. The Rendlesham Forest incident was the closest and most identifiable UFO sighting of the early 1980s. Sixth, Hudson Valley sightings. There have been various reported sightings of UFO in the Hudson Valley for centuries. On September 24, 1983, a motorist reported seeing a very bright object in the sky which managed to be visible. The Hudson Valley sightings are often attributed to Paul Benowitz, who became convinced signals he was picking up were of an alien origin. This is thought to be the origin of the myth of the MJ-12 government documents. 7th, Phoenix Lights Incident. It was only in 1997 that the first sighting of the so-called Phoenix Lights was reported. These three events are what the UFO community calls Nick Redfern's three lights that changed everything. The 8th, 9th, and 10th. The Hestalen, Shag Harbor, and Tehran UFO Incident. The Hestalen lights are a phenomenon that mainly occurs in Norway. They are formed by the ionization of the atmosphere and by the movement or activity hundreds of kilometers up in the atmosphere. You can see them as they flash and move quickly through the sky. The Shag Harbor UFO crash happened on 4 December 1967. When a Canadian cargo ship found itself ramming into what is believed to be a giant boy. Instead, they found themselves looking at a domed object. As for the Tehran UFO incident, it was said to be one of the most important UFO incidents up until the late 70s when it was covered up. The Tehran UFO incident is when three round-shaped flying objects, fluttering in formation, were spotted over Tehran. To conclude, UFO sighting has been there for a long time. The question is the UFO unidentified foreign objects really of alien origin? Or a concoction of our imagination? UFO are real, not fake. But not all news on UFO is real. Thanks for watching. Watch out for this space for more Buzz News. Like, subscribe, and share. Signing off.